Please hit the subscribe button and tap the bell icon for the future notification to watch more videos of latest fashions and trends. Thank you so much for your love.
Hello friends, welcome back to Amazing Women's. In this video, I've come up with Janhvi Kapoor inspired outfit made for her movie promotion Dhadak, which I'm very much loving. She's really looking gorgeous with her eye blasting look. And really friends, this pattern has inspired me a lot. Hope you like it. All the credits goes to famous designer Manish Malhotra for designing this pattern. Wanna give detailed brief about this pattern? The bodice is designed with Angraka pattern. Elevated the bodice with the cold shoulders, dory hangings, defining on the waistline with the buttons. And the kallis with asymmetric joint of two colors, orange and yellow, defining the pattern, giving the slit in the center front. Not wasting much time, let's quickly start with this project. And the materials I'm gonna use is 2 meters yellow fabric and 3 meters orange color fabric. Both I'm using of polyester fabric. अब आप इस वीडियो को हिंदी में देख सकते हैं. चैनल का लिंक आपके सामने है. चैनल डिटेल्स डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में भी अवेलेबल है. प्लीज क्लिक कीजिए अमेजिंग एबीसी फैशन चैनल को और देखते रहिए लेटेस्ट फैशन और ट्रेंडी वीडियोस को. सब्सक्राइब करना मत भूलिए. इट्स ए फुल लेंथ कुर्ता ऑफ 50 इंचेस विच आई टुक फॉर द बॉडीज ऑफ 16 इंच ऑरेंज कलर पैनल लेंथ विद लेंथ ऑफ 25 इंचेस एंड येलो कली लेंथ ऑफ 15 इंच. आई एम टेकिंग एक्स्ट्रा ऑफ 6 इंचेस with the total because for the kallis it's an asymmetric and the bodice measurement for the adult size is in front of you. Also I'll show you how to mark it using the same measurements. First we'll make the bodice for the back panel which I took on the fold, marking the shoulder length of 6.5 inches because I'm preparing this for the sleeveless, and neck width would be of 3 inches. With the seam 11.25 inch in, we have to mark it, and the armhole length is of 7 inches. Chest length is 32 inches divided by 4 is 8 inches and half an inch is I'm adding, so 8.5 inches I'd be marking on the chest line with 1 inch seam allowance. Connecting these points with the perpendicular line, also marking midpoint of the armhole with the curved line like this. 28 inches is the waist length, so fourth part of that would be of 7 inches and half an inch ease I'm adding. Total we'll get 2 inches ease, so 7.5 inches would be the waist length and 1 inch seam allowance. Connecting these points with the parallel lines. Now I'll cut on these marked lines. I'm sorry, forgot to mark the neckline. The neck depth would be of 3 inches. With the U-shaped neckline I'd be marking. Now I'll cut on these marked lines. For the front panel, to prepare Angraka pattern, I'll be using the chart to draft the pattern, placing the back panel on the fold of the chart and transforming the measurements accordingly. Marking half an inch arm side depth curve in. I'll leave the neckline first, trimming on these marked lines. Now the neck depth I'll be marking is of 8 inches. From the waistline I'd be marking 5 inches above like this. Now connecting these points with the curved shape, the neck depth, and from this shoulder line, these three points joining with the curved shape. I will cut on this shape. For making the front bodice, I'd be preparing two panels. For that, I'd be using this two piece of fabric. Laying the draft pattern, I'll transform the markings. Placing right sides together, I'm giving the markings towards wrong side. Markings is done. Accordingly, I'll cut on this marked shape. I'll mark it as wrong on both the sides so that it won't be get confused while joining. Like this, we have to lay both the panels. Then with the back panel like this. At the time of joining, I'll show you how to align it, but this I'll cut off at the apex point. Leaving 1-inch seam allowance, I'll cut it because we have to double fold it here like this and give the stitch. Done with the bodice cutting, let's start with the culleys or the panels making. Let's see with the culleys calculation. The waist length I'd be preparing is of 28 inches and 2 inches is I'm adding. So now it become 30 inches. I'd be preparing 14 panels. So waist length divided by number of panels, that is 14, which would be 2.14 inches. I'm adding 0.75 inches seam allowance. Now it's 2.75 inches. On the waistline for each culley, that means of 14 culleys with each panel length on the waistline 2.75 inches. Now for drafting of the culley, I'd be using this folded chart with the length of 40 inches. You can clearly see here. So on the waistline, it's on fold, right? So we have to divide by 2. 2.8 divided by 2 is 1.4 inches on the waistline. This we have to mark on the fold, 1.4 inches. And the culley length flare I'd be taking is of 2.5 inches. Total 5 inches. So it's on fold, right? So we'll take 2.5 inches. Now I'll join these two points with a slanting line like this. These measurements can be customized as per your requirement. If you want more flare, you can increase the length of the flare accordingly. This way we have to join both the points with a slanting line. This would be the waist length of 1.4 inches and this would be flare width of 2.5 inches on the fold. I will cut on this marked lines. From the bottom, marking towards up with the length of 15 inches. So this 15 inches I'd be marking for the yellow fabric and remaining 25 inches for the orange. So now I'll cut on this marked line so that we can cut the panel colors accordingly. Once the cutting of the panels is done, we have to join the panels later. So now let's see how to cut it. Firstly, I'm taking orange fabric with a length of 2 meters. I'm giving 8 folds. You can clearly see here. Now I've given single fold with 2 layers like this. We have to make 8 folds into 16 layers. As we have to make 14 panels, we cannot fold. So accordingly we have to fold 7 times, but it's not possible to fold 7. So I've given 8 folds, which is of 16 layers right now. And on this, I'll place the draft pattern and transform the markings. Now I'll give the markings of this slanting line. Ensure that both sides you should have the same length, the panels which we are preparing. So I'm cutting on this marked shape. We require only 14 panels, but we have trimmed 16 panels. So the joint panels I am taking away, and this would be the panels which is of 14, each side 7 and 7. This would be for the back and front, each of 7. The joining strips should be taken away. These strips I'll use for the concealing of these panels, as we are giving the slit in the center frame. So keep these panels for the concealing of the center frame slit. Now the same way, I'll cut for the yellow panels, giving 8 folds like how I've shown previously. Now this is of 16 layers, so I'll unfold it and I'll mark it accordingly. You can see here it's on 8 layers. I'll separate these panels to make into 16, giving the center slanting slit and also on the fold to separate. I'll keep the remaining leftover pieces as it is, because as we are making an asymmetric pattern, we require more panels to join. So for that sake, we have to secure these leftovers. Firstly, we'll cut according to the draft pattern, but also secure the leftovers so that I'll show you the remaining panels how to join. Now these are also 16 panels, so I'm taking off 2 more panels, as we would require only 14. complete stitching tutorial will be followed next with the easy making of this pattern. Stay continuing to watch. This is how the yellow panels would look. We have to join the orange colors followed with the yellow colors. Stay tuned to watch the concluding part of complete makeover of this beautiful pattern in the next video. Hope you enjoyed watching this video. Please hit the like icon to support my efforts. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe to Amazing Women's World channel. Stay tuned to watch more videos of latest fashions and trends. See you all. Bye for now.